Hello and welcome students to the lectures on cervical carcinoma. And since I'm teaching cervical carcinoma this week, I'm today going to be discussing about the FIGO classification of cervical carcinoma. A classification in which I used to get confused a lot, because FIGO classification is there for all kind of cancers which we are going to discuss about. And it used to confuse me every time, you know, stage 1A1, 1A2, B1, B2. So today's class, I have tried to dedicate it to making it easy. I'm going to give you tips and tricks to make FIGO classification according to the cancer, that means a specific cancer wise, easy to remember in your mind. So just watch up close and try to get the gist of it. Let's start. So what I've made on the black, on the whiteboard is actually a diagram to make it easy as we go. Now I'm going to ask you questions, and if you will answer yourself, and I'm going to stage it, right? So this actually, the FIGO classification is based upon clinical staging along with the the imaging staging. All right, so this is a help of biopsy, the clinical staging, and also the imaging study. So in together, in total, we are making the FIGO classification. Let's start, and let's just go conceptually towards this classification. So basically, let's start with cervix. If at all a cancer is to start in the cervix, what stage will you call it? Stage 1. I'll say we'll call it stage 1 when it is limited to the cervix, or maximum it has gone into the uterus somewhere, because uterus is a part of, cervix is a part of the uterus. So even if it goes to the corpus, it is included in stage 1. It has still not invaded the surrounding structures. It's in the cervix or in the uterus. So if you remove the uterus, cancer is not spilled away. All right, so that will be stage 1. Remember, stage 1, I mean, is the stage in which the cancer is in the cervix only. It has not gone in any other surrounding structure. What is stage 2 then? Where would the cancer, after it has gone in the cervix, it is spreading in the cervix, where will it go? It will go to the upper two-third vagina or the perimetrium. Stage 2 will be that it is either gone into the, upper two-third vagina, or it has invaded the perimetrium, but it has not yet reached the pelvic wall, the side wall. It is not that much, advanced. So stage 2. Two-third vagina, upper two-third vagina. Why am I saying upper two-third vagina? Because that's where it's going to go. Where else will it go? It will go to the upper, right? Around cervix is what? So the vagina. And the upper vagina, it will go closer to the cervix. It's in close lining with the upper two-third of the vagina, right? And maximum, it will go to the perimetrium. Now, if a person comes to you, this is also one of the conceptual, questions I'm asking. If a patient comes to you and this tumor is right there in front of your eyes, the typical cauliflower appearance, the confluent edges, the discharge and everything, the foul smell, you saw and you feel you have that thing that, it is a CA cervix case. So what do? You do, of course, after PS, you do the PD examination. What do you see in that? Now, first of all, you will try to see whether this tumor, it has eroded the vagina also, or is it only on the cervix. So if you put your finger and you can feel the cervix all around in the upper part of the vagina, it is already stage 2. It is already stage 2. Even if it is, even if it's a part of vagina, it is stage 2. It is spread. So you don't have to go to perimetrium also in this case. Okay, now if you see the tumor and it has reached the perimetrium by your PV examination, you can't find, you feel that the tumor is all around. It has gone to the perimetrium. Whether it has reached the pelvic wall, this is imaging studies will tell you. But whether it is all around, that your hand will tell you also. You can do PR examination also. Of course, that is a part of your, examination when you can see a cervical tumor. So that means, and what I'm trying to tell you is, put it in your, clinical scenario. So when you see a tumor which has eroded the edges of the vagina as well, stage 2. You're doing a PV and you can feel the tumor all around, stage 2. But what is stage 3 then? Stage 3. After, what do you think now? after this two third of the vagina, where is it going to go? To the lower one third vagina. Also, since I said it has reached the perimeterium and not pelvic wall, stage 3 will be what? Stage 3 will be what? It will reach the pelvic wall. The idea of saying that it has not reached the pelvic wall in stage 2 is that the stage 3 means it has reached the pelvic wall. So basically stage 3 is lower one third vagina, pelvic side walls. Okay. Hydronephrosis. Why do I say hydronephrosis? Or a functioning one kidney. Why do I say hydronephrosis? Because by the time it has involved the perimeterium and gone to the pelvic wall, side wall, do you think the ureter will be spared? Ureter will not be spared. And once the ureter also comes into, you know, the tumor, it gets, you know, by the pressure effect, by the necrosis, it gets atritic. And because of that, there is backflow and hydronephrosis. So now do you understand why it's very easy to understand FIGO staging? So stage 3, hydronephrosis. And of course, your pelvic lymph nodes, how will they be left? So pelvic lymph nodes and para-aortic lymph nodes will also come in stage 3. Mind you, I have not yet gone into 1A1, 1A1, 1A2 or 1A1B. I have not yet done that. I'm just trying to make it easy conceptually, the FIGO staging. Once you know this thing, it's very easy for me to go to the next step. Okay, so pelvic lymph nodes, which in case of cervical carcinoma happen to be internal iliac, external iliac and obturator lymph nodes. Also, the para-aortic lymph nodes, because obviously the pelvic lymph nodes, they drain into the aortic, the para-aortic lymph nodes. So all these, you know, blood vessels, they have their respective respective lymph nodes, in which these things, they drain into the lymphatic channels of their respective name of these arteries. Aorta has its own channel, external iliac, common iliac, internal iliac. They all have their own lymph nodes. And then finally, obturator lymph nodes are specific for cervical carcinoma. So anyways, and of course, stage 4, like in all cases of FIGO staging, stage 4 happens to be the bladder, the rectal involvement, and the spread beyond the pelvis. Lungs, the to liver, lungs, brain and stuff. So this was the very basic conceptual the FIGO staging. In the next segment, I'm going to talk about 1A1, 1A2, 1B1 and so on.